Hey everybody, welcome back to Stamping School. I got a request from Sandy from Orlando to use this festive post. It's on page 63 of the Stampin' Up! Holiday Catalog 2020. It's a nice photopolymer stamp set, and these three images will punch out using the rectangular postage punch. So this punch is in the annual catalog, page 168, 2020. And you can see what a cute little sample that is right there. That's kind of cute. But it bundles with another stamp set, Posted for You, right here. And it'll punch out these three. So in the Stampin' Up! Catalog, anytime you see something that has like a gray shadow around it, that means there are metal die cuts that will cut those out. And if you see this creamish yellow over an image, that means it's a punch. So good to know what those two different colors are. So Sandy asked for a nice holiday card using that stamp set, something that wasn't too hard but looked like she made an effort. I love that because that is really you gotta step it up just a little bit, but you don't want it so hard that making 50 of them is going to take you 3 months, right? So this one's not too bad. It's kind of right in the middle. All right, so I've got Real Red for my card base, and then I've got Pool Party, and we're going to do a little frame. Now, this rectangle punch is great because it'll make this rectangle right here, which does coordinate with the stamp set nicely. So if you look right here, I've punched it out. It will go over all of these right here. And it kind of has all these different images in there. It's got Christmas, it's got Halloween, it's got Valentine's Day or just love. So it's got lots of different things in here. But I wanted to make a bigger window for the deer. Even though it would fit in here, I wanted it to be bigger. So this one is embossed with the subtle embossing folder, and you want a panel that's 4 inches by 5 1/4, so it looks like this. And then you need another piece of paper that's the same size, and that's what's going to layer behind it. Okay, so we're going to stamp into the windows. This one is embossed with a snowflake folder, and I'm going to see if I like that. So here's what I did. We're going to go into the top from the right and up so that the metal end of the punch here matches the paper. That's going to be your first punch. And then you can save that. That's pretty. And then we're going to come in from the bottom right here. And if you go up so the paper matches the edge of the punch right there. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So we're going to line up this side with the punch and punch again. And because we've come all the way in from the top, it's gonna be a nice, perfect window like that. Now, if you wanted to with this punch, you could come down and you could punch three windows this way. You could easily make this a shaker card by adding the foam strips around and putting things underneath it with a window sheet. So it's really versatile. So now we're gonna do the stamping. We're gonna put these two behind each other. I wonder if I need to do this on black. This back to black. All right, let me see this. There we go. I'm going to move this back to black so you can see. Let me see. I'm going to move my background back to black again so you can see. I want to tack this down, but not permanently. I don't want to glue it down in case I mess up. I'm going to take just a couple of little post-it flags and just hold that down just a little bit. All right, here's my colors I'm gonna use. Garden Green, Real Red, Soft Suede, and Pool Party. So I'm gonna show you a little trick of how to get the car red and the tree green. Starting with Soft Suede everywhere. I'm gonna stamp that right, I'm gonna go over just a touch because I've got that snowflake coming in. Photopolymer makes it really nice. You can see what you're doing. There it is. Now the tree is a two-step that comes in the set. We're gonna do that in Garden Green and come right in and line that up right there. And now for the red. So what you're gonna do is clean this off and stamp it again in red. And then stamp your tree on top also because it needs that little touch of green right there. So once you stamp that with red, we're gonna cut out just the body of the car. So I know it's a little bit extra work, but what's nice is it's gonna save a lot of time of having to color all of this with markers or trying to figure out how to get all three colors on there or just coloring it with one color, which never looks as nice. And then this, just the body of that car is just going to cover the brown that we already stamped. And there it is. My little Post-it flags were not holding for me, so I got to use a big Post-it note. There we go. Now, this down here, we're going to do the deer in soft suede. And he's going to go over to the right just a little bit. Over on the left. He's going to go over on the left just a little bit. There he is. Now I've got a little bit of room for some snowflakes. In the balmy blue, I'm going to put one here. And I'm going to put one, do one up here. And I want one right in that corner. But some of it may be covered up, so I'm going to pull that away. So there's the stamping for the windows. Now there's this little circle right here. It says it's the most wonderful time of the year. I'm going to stamp this in the corner. And because that's going to be covered up, I'm going to take it right from there. If you have a 3/4 inch circle punch, that fits perfectly. So here we go. Make sure the ends are glued down nicely. All the little corners. And this goes right over top. Because it's pretty much the same size, you know, it's going to line up nicely. So you just don't want the white to be bigger so it doesn't show through. All right, then the whole thing goes on real red. Right there. I love that little bit of slide time. No ribbon on this one, but we did do some snowflakes. These are from the snowflakes in the holiday catalog. I've got three here that I chose. See, on this one, I did two large, and I'm going to play around to see if I need to change the size on this one. Nope, I'm going to keep them the same. So we're going to add just a little bit of glue right here. And then this guy just needs to be stamped in the middle with a little snowflake. Same little one that comes in the set in the pool party, right in the center. I love those photopolymer, you can see through. Dimensional on the back, just to make it pop up. And ta-da, right there. And this one, we're just gonna put a little bit of glue, one in the middle, just teeny little, and then a little rhinestone. Put that right here. We have to put our sentiment on here, and then I'll show you what I did with the inside. A couple rhinestones scattered around. Why not? If you put one on, you might as well put four more. Okay. Now the sentiment, I could just leave it there if you want to, but what I really like is this little tiny banner because the red will repeat three times. Red car, red card, and red sentiment. I have a little piece, 1/4 inch, and this itty bitty little to you and yours. And we're gonna do that in red, just to have the rule of three. There we go. And I'm gonna have my banner come this way. So we're gonna cut it off, cut up in the middle. I don't know if you can see, it's so tiny. Up in the middle, and then on the two sides. I got ink on there. There we go. I got ink on my finger. See that? That's going to be a problem. And I love these dimensional strips. They're perfect for these little skinny greetings. They got the adhesive on both sides and they stand up nice and tall. Now they almost need a magnifying glass to read that. But it does say it's the most wonderful time of the year. And then to you and yours, right here. And then on the inside, I'm gonna write a little note, but this is what I just did. I stamped a little tree, a couple snowflakes, and then this little border right here was created with this stamp right here. I just turned it on its side and I stamped a white piece of paper, and I was able to get three little borders out of it going across and just glued that right along the bottom there. So here's the two next to each other. I think that I like the subtle better. It's a little less busy, but it's got the nice texture on here. So I'll post the picture for this one. And remember, you can print the recipe with all the measurements over on my blog, and the link is in the description. All right, we'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. See it, learn it, stamp it.